Hello, welcome to this rendition of On the Records. I'm Ali Jackson. This week we're talking about the one and only Terrence Blanchard, and we're gonna review some highlights of his amazing release, Terrence Blanchard, from 1991. Some really interesting things about Terrence's writing, his composing, and also the amazing ensemble that plays on this recording. The first song is Wandering Wonder. This is an original composition, and it highlights the burnout type of style of playing from the 80s into the 90s. And so what I mean by burnout, it's a way of like collective playing based on rhythmic, you could call them strettos or rhythmic riffs that everyone plays, like an interlocking rhythms inside of the rhythm section with the soloist kind of leading this or playing around it, and it builds up to resolutions. So this is very evident in the styles of John Coltrane's quartet, Elvin Jones, Jimmy Garrison, and Steve Davis, and McCoy Tyner, and also Reggie Workman in there too. In this way of playing, the band builds up into like a big resolution. So in the way that John Coltrane's band played, it was kind of constant motion, like waves. If you think about like a wave rolling in, and then it crashing, and they constantly are doing that, kind of more in a circular type of fashion. In the burnout style, it could be over free music, all improvised, or it could be in the context of forms. And the resolutions can be anywhere. They're not necessarily at the top of the actual technical form or how the song is written. They can resolve anywhere inside of the form. So let's check out Wandering Wonder. Two, three, four, five. One, two, two, three, four, five, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five. So the solo section is broken into two halves. So there's a 9-bar phrase that goes into a 7-bar phrase, or you could look at it as an 8-bar phrase with the next part of the phrase, a catch phrase, divides the two phrases. So that consistently comes every time inside of the form. A catch phrase or an anchor where everyone's anchored back into where they are inside of the cycle. See the theme? And notice the way Terrence is phrasing, it's around in the context of the 5 phrase, and then when he goes to swinging, now he changes his lines. He starts playing more swinging lines inside of the time in the 4-4 swing. Theme. Space. Theme. Finished his phrase and left it opening for the catchphrase. So I want to stop because Terrence is playing in a very super logical musical way. In the sections that they're playing, ding, 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 ding. He's playing more wide. He's not playing a lot of notes. He's playing longer phrases, which allows that the music that you still hear the pulse and the rhythm, and he's painting in a way in the spaces and using the space. And then when he gets to the swing section, he plays more inside of the swing time in that field. And he's going back and forth, and he's leaving space, and he's playing phrases. So when he plays a phrase, it leaves space for the rest of the cast in the band to respond and react to what he's playing, and vice versa. He hears what they play, and he's playing in reference to what they're doing. So it's this this call and response and ebb and flow of how they're playing. Bridge the gap into the saxophone solo. And he's building on that theme. And so right off the bat, Branford Marsalis is playing the center saxophone. He's using the same concept, the way of playing, the way he structured his solo from the beginning of how Terrence structured his solo. On the groove section of the tune, he's playing with more space and in a wider way, bigger phrases, like in a big overall unit of time. And when they get to the swing, he plays inside of the swing rhythm. So it's like those two sides. Themes. In the cracks of the groove. Themes, playing repeated phrases and shapes. So that is also a trademark of playing Burnout. When you play a rhythm or a rhythmic idea or phrase and you repeat it, it allows everybody else to join in. When you constantly repeat it, then someone else plays another phrase that's complementary to that phrase. And then another person plays another phrase that's complementary. So you build up all of this rhythmic energy. It's like a hurricane. You start building up this energy, and so the energy is moving. So you get it moving, and then the rhythm section can keep building it up. You build it up to a resolution, and then you build it up again. It's like waves and cycles. In this rhythm section, there are actually two different kind of configurations on this record, and we'll get into that later. However, on this particular song, obviously, you have Terrence Blanchard, Branford Marsalis on the tenor saxophone, and the rhythm section, Bruce Barth, great pianist, Rodney Whitaker, hometown, big money on the bass, and none other than Jeff Tane Watts on drums. They play extremely free over it, but no one is ever lost. And it's the logic and the level of concentration and detail and how they're playing with each other that they never get lost. And it's all it makes a whole lot of sense of how they're playing. So for the untrained ear, it might just be like, it's a whole bunch of stuff going on. They know exactly what they're doing. We're going to move on to another song on this album, one of my favorites, also an original by Mr. Terrence Blanchard. This is entitled Sing Soweto. It's an extremely beautiful melody, strong melody, and a very simple tune. However, he uses some very unique and, flavored harmony to this very simple melody. And this has also become kind of a trademark of Mr. Terrence Blanchard's sound. So let's check it out. This is Sing Soweto. And on this song, you have Troy Davis playing the drums. You can notice his drum sound is different, very different than Jeff Tane Watts' sound. This is not a Burnout. This is, I would say, it's a combination of, it's like six, it's not really in 3/4, it's in like six.
I meant to say 9/8, not six.
My bad.
And it's a haunting melody, repetitive melody, and then here's the bridge, which brings you into a whole different place. Energy and motion. So build up and then come down. Like a chant. and it's very calm. A lot of space around it. And it's, everyone's playing very, everyone is in their lane. No one's out of their lane. And this is a solo, obviously. You know, he plays a phrase, and takes his time. He builds up into the bridge. Left space for the bass to respond, like conversation, call and response. And Troy Davis is just painting in color, keeping the time, and inserting energy where the phrases lie. You'll check it out. And Bruce Barth is just coloring beautifully. Back to the head. Head out. This song is about 4 minutes. However, Terrence makes a statement. There's a little bit of dialogue with the bass and trumpet. He paints on the form, on the harmony. And then he's back to expressing the main sentiment of the tune. And it's called Sing Soweto. In honor and homage to those that survived apartheid. Man, I wish I knew where Troy. I need to find him. If he sees this video, we need to connect. This is one of my heroes, mentors, Troy Davis, Jeff Tane Watts. All of these cats were extreme influences for people in my generation growing up playing the music. Anytime Terrence Blanchard would come to town, and when, you know, when I was in high school, we'd be rushing to go see them. I remember, like, soon after the film Malcolm X came out, which Terrence wrote music for that film. Before that, obviously, he was working with Spike Lee, but that was a huge film, especially growing up in Detroit. And the story of Malcolm X is obviously is seminal in the world. We would always go and try and see them play. And I remember going to see Terrence Blanchard, Bruce Barth, Troy Davis. I think it might have been Rodney, but I don't think it was Rodney. It might have been Charles Mateen playing bass. And they played somewhere in the suburbs at the Magic Bag Theater. And I'll never forget, you know, the energy and the vibe of them playing all of that music live from Malcolm X. But Terrence is a one-of-a-kind, extremely brilliant composer, obviously trumpeter, band leader, and just very tasteful, very thoughtful in his music. And this is why we're checking out Terrence Blanchard.
Thanks for watching. And if you like this video, please check out our other videos. Comment if there's something you would like me to react to. And if you think this is valuable information, be sure to share it with a friend. And as always, we'll see you at the gig.